name's Trevor Alonzo. This is my review of In Search of Darkness, the ultimate 80s horror documentary. This is a massive 4-hour, 4-minute documentary that goes over horror movies in the 1980s. This does go in order of year by year from 1980 to 1989, so it is expected to be long. I've seen other horror documentaries on TV that are around 2 hours, but I'm more than sure that this is the longest I've ever seen. I first found out about this documentary from fellow YouTuber Oliver Harper. He does such great retrospectives and documentaries on YouTube. I do recommend checking out his channel. He did direct In Search of the Last Action Hero. I will review that another time. He is involved in this one. I got involved in this documentary when it was on Kickstarter. I became an affiliate on YouTube, which is why my channel has so many advertisements for it. I was able to give some minor input in this documentary. I was able to see the rough cut. I gave them some notes. And I thought to myself, okay, maybe a few hundred people saw the rough cut. I was pleasantly surprised to find out only 20 people got to see the rough cut. So that was very cool to be one of the few. They interviewed a lot of people from the movies and horror industry for this. Here are some of the names: Cassandra Peterson, John Carpenter, Heather Langenkamp, Joe Dante, Jeffrey Combs, Barbara Crampton, David Keith, Greg Nicotero, Bill Moseley, Kane Hodder, Sean S. Cunningham, Tom Holland, James Roth, Alex Winter, Joe Bob Briggs, and there's a lot more. If I read off every name, I'd be reading off names all day. That's not to say I didn't think the rest were entertaining. I love this whole documentary. And I do like how they did other segments to break up the documentary. They had a segment about music and horror movies. They had a segment about soundtracks. They had a segment about horror movie products. I kind of talked about the Freddy Krueger doll. I like the part about the video rentals, which they talked about a really cheap Tom Savini Jack the Ripper movie that was literally filmed on VHS. And probably a warehouse. They talked about horror movie toys. All the interviews were done really well. I'm glad they were able to get so many involved. And they covered so much. Now, they didn't go in-depth for each movie. They covered 80s horror movies as a whole. And they weren't able to cover every single horror movie in the 80s. That's partly the main reason they are making a sequel. I do understand that people are wanting coverage of every single movie and to do a deep dive into each one. That's not possible, really. You could make a good documentary about each movie by themselves. And there are great documentaries about individual horror movies. Me and my wife really got into this once we started watching it. We kind of started thinking about, okay, maybe an hour a night to finish the whole thing. But once we started watching it, we finished it in 2 nights. The extras on the DVD or Blu-ray are really cool. One of them was a walkthrough of an effects museum. The score for this is amazing. It sounds very 80s tech. I was able to get a copy of the soundtrack, which I enjoy listening to on its own. My main complaint about this is the first wave of packaging. The company they used first did a horrible job. It was put on recorded Blu-rays or DVDs. People got the wrong version sent to them. I knew someone that ordered the Elvira version. He got his later than mine. I got mine literally the day before New Year's Eve. The packaging was terrible. I got lucky that the card that comes with it wasn't bent, but I heard some people theirs was kind of bent or messed up. I've also heard some people say that the posters they ordered were folded instead of rolled up. The DVD case for mine was like a dollar store quality. I just went ahead and put it in a better case. I heard some discs did not work. Again, I was very lucky mine worked. They have switched companies for future projects. They fixed a lot of orders and sent better versions out, but you did have to contact them right away for it. I don't really have spoilers. How do you spoil a documentary like this? Spoiler alert, the 80s ended and the 90s began. It's cool to watch all the year segments, or even just pop it in and throw it in at random and watch like the side segments. I do highly recommend this, even though the packaging at first was bad. So for my rating, I'm giving this documentary a 10 out of 10 VHS tapes. But for the original packaging, this brought my rating down to an 8 out of 10. It's hard to get someone interested in watching something that I was involved in when they look at it and they see this and they're like, this looks like a dollar store movie. Not that I'm knocking dollar store movies. Some of those are pretty good. But it did look like something that belongs in a discount bin at Walmart. I still recommend seeing this. It's currently streaming. If you love 80s horror movies, or just horror movies, then you'll love this. Thank you for watching my video.